Hello, my name is Joshua Lett, and I'm a COM 231 public speaking student. Thank you for having me here today. According to Yala Adler's Doing Business in Mexico, roughly 65% of our communication is nonverbal, and the other 35% is verbal, which just means that our culture, the way we express ourselves through our dress and expressions, are very important. According to the U.S. Census in 2013, Hispanic constitute of 17% of the nation's total population. Therefore, getting to know the Hispanic culture is very important and knowing how to interact with each other. I personally learned the Hispanic culture as I lived there in Mexico for 10 years. So let me inform you on some of the key aspects to the uniqueness of Mexico's culture. We'll be looking at food, artistic expression, and values. First, we have foods. Mexico is known for its street food, which are called antojitos, and its desserts and drinks. Antojitos are oftentimes trailer vendors, and specific foods are burritos, gorditas, bolillos, frijoles charros, and nachos. Predominantly, all these foods are very spicy. Also, the desserts, arroz con leche, flan, pastel de tres leches, empanadas, all very milk-rich based substances. And then for three, we have drinks, aguas de horchata, jarritos, ponche, and tequila. Mexico's artistic expression consists of its music, art, and clothing. A very popular style form of this music are the mariachi, which consists of violins, guitars, bass, five string guitars, and even trumpets. And as you can see, it's wearing silver-studded charro suits and elaborate hats. La cucaracha is a very well-known piece for this. You have the figure art, mine relics, clay pottery, embroidered cotton garments, colorful baskets, and rugs, some of the common items associated with the folk art, as you can see as well. For your clothing, the style is very similar to America's. It's very modern, but if you look back, for women, the wardrobe includes skirts, sleeveless tunics called yobels, capes known as quechequemilts, and shawls called rebozos. And for men, clothing is a large blanket cape called a sarape, boots, and jeans. Very important part of the culture is family values. Mexicans put a high value on hierarchy and structure in the business, and family does matter. Families are typically large, and Mexicans are very conscious of their responsibilities to immediate family and extended family, such as cousins and even close friends. Hosting parties at their homes plays a large part of Mexican life in making visitors feel comfortable and welcome as a part of their valued customs of the country. Like all countries, in cultures, Mexico's culture is unique in its own ways. The food, the artistic expression, and the values are a few of the ways how Mexico is very different. We all have our own culture, so let's take the time to look at someone else's and get to know and learn. So, any of you guys have any questions?
What was your favorite food when you lived in Mexico?
The tacos de barbacoa, which were cow tongue, and you would add a lot of spice and salsa to make it very good.
Ew.
Any other questions? Well, thank you guys so much for having me here today, and I hope you learned something new.
Alright.